Hey, good morning everybody and welcome to the vlog. I hope the start of your day is absolutely incredible. We have a busy day today. We have an unboxing, we're working on the podcast room, getting it drywall, and I actually have to go try to save some baby snakes' lives. And what I mean by that is I have to assist feed some baby ball pythons. I'm gonna take you along on the journey. Let's push our problems aside, have an amazing day together. What do you say we head down to the dungeon and assist feed some baby ball pythons? So this morning is actually the morning that we get to start seeing the sheetrock in this room. So I know we had some kind of delays because we're changing electrical around. I talked about the VIP podcasting and all that type of stuff. So today we actually get the sheetrock. So these rooms are going to go from studs to actually having drywall up on them, get it taped out. Hopefully in the next couple days all that will be done. And then I can go into this room and actually rock out all these walls with universal rock so they look really cool. Put some flooring in, get things rolling. Obviously the windows go in here. So a lot of work to be done. But if everything goes well in about a week, we should be done with this project and start moving on to the outer part of the basement, which is going to take us probably another at least month and a half to get completely done, but it's going to be cool. But it's cool to finally be making some progress down here. It's going to look a lot different at the end of the day. You have 1,000 baby ball pythons, you can't expect every one of them to just thrive and eat, right? So we have about a dozen or 15 ball pythons that are at that stage that I basically say we need to do something, right? Basically what I mean by that is that they hatched, they shed, they should eat within about 5 to 7 days after that shed maximum. So I offer them food. If they refuse food 3 times, then we're at this stage right here. This is a fire mimosa, which is a fire, it's a ghost, and it's a champagne. Beautiful snake, hasn't eaten now. So basically it's about 5 weeks old, no food. We've tried live fuzzy mice, we've tried live fuzzy rats, and we've also tried frozen. Now at this point, we could just continue to keep going, but it's just gonna start losing weight. So what I think you do is you assist feed, and I'm gonna show you guys how I actually go through this process, right? And it's a relatively painless thing for the animal and can really get things kick-started. But before I get started, I want to just preface by saying, number one, if you have a snake that has fed and has went 3, 4, 5 weeks, 2 months, whatever, I do not want you to assist feed your snake. I have never assist fed a snake that has taken a meal voluntarily on its own ever in my entire career, and I don't want you guys to do that. I always hear people say, oh, my ball python's eaten for a month, I'm gonna assist feed it. Please don't do that, okay? Only fresh babies that have never eaten, we assist feed, and I've told you now, they're about 5 weeks old, been offered 3 times, refused, and then basically what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a fuzzy mouse that's about this size. You can see the size of the head. I want it to be a little smaller than the head, right? Because I want it to kind of feel like it's trapped in there. The snake is going to want to spit this out, right? So we have to get it in its mouth to where a point where it kind of goes, oh, I can't get this out of my mouth. I might as well eat it, right? And then now getting that in there and actually letting it swallow it, not forcing it down its throat, is going to actually entice it to start eating again. Typically between 1 and 3 assist feedings is when the snake takes off. And what I'm going to do is assist feed, then I'm going to offer it food in about 5 days. If it doesn't eat, I'm going to assist feed again. I'm going to offer it food 5 days later until it finally eats on its own. I have huge success with this. I mean, very, very few animals don't thrive. But what I want to do is, again, very gently take this snake right here, and I'm gonna just kinda just gently get its head like this, right? I'm gonna really carefully just use the actual fuzzy to open its mouth, just like this. And again, I'm gonna be super gentle with this snake right now. Right like that, see, now it's opened up. Now what I wanna do is actually push it a little bit in, I'm not force feeding it, pushing it a little bit in. I want it to get a little bit stuck on its teeth. Now this is the trick that a lot of people miss that I have huge success with, is once it's in there pretty good, I let it go and I let it hang like this. I don't put it down immediately, right? So right now I'm letting it hang for a second, it's getting, now I'm gonna gently put it down when it stops going crazy. Gonna gently put it down, and I'm just gonna walk away for a second. Now, basically what's gonna happen is it's either gonna eat right now, it may spit it out. I may have to do this 2, 3, 4 times until it finally says, you know what, I've gotta eat this, and it actually eats it. So I'm gonna quietly walk away, we're gonna see what happens. And you can see right now, it's actually trying to spit it out, right? It's doing everything it can do to get it out of its mouth. Now, it may be successful, and if it's successful, I have to start over and try again. But at some point, it's gonna kinda give up, and it's gonna go, oh my gosh, this thing is in my mouth, I might as well just go ahead and swallow it. And you'll see when it starts to actually take that first bite, that's when you know, all right, success. Continue to stay away from it from afar, looking at what it's doing. And you can kind of see right now it's taking a couple little test bites. Once it starts, there it goes, see? Right now, you can see it's eating on its own. That's what you want right there. Once this thing does this two or three times, it's teaching itself to eat, right? I'm not forcing it to eat, it's eating on its own. But again, you have to be super gentle and super patient, and this will literally save this animal's life rather than just letting it not eat because maybe it just doesn't understand how to eat. We're teaching it, and this is an absolute proven technique that I've been doing for the last 25 years that will save baby ball pythons' lives that are just finicky and won't start eating. And that is it. I mean, how amazing is that? It doesn't always happen on the first try. Like I said, sometimes I have to do 2-3 ties before I actually get success. But this animal here, and I'm just gonna gently put it back right now, this animal here literally is on the road to success now. I mean, literally, I know it may seem weird, but I'm not trying to overemphasize the fact that, you know, that could save its life, right? I mean, the fact that it has calories in it now and isn't losing weight is huge. Now, if I can maybe get it to eat next week, great. If not, I assist feed. Then I go again and again until they finally do it. So what do you say we do one more snake, see how it works out, give you guys that real feel for maybe another snake that gives me a little bit harder time. I don't know what's gonna happen. Put this one back and then we'll move on and we'll just crush out the rest of them. Next up is this absolutely gorgeous piebald. And the thing that's nice about this one is that it hasn't really lost hardly any weight, so it looks really good. Ironically enough, usually when they look good like this, they give you a little bit of harder time. That's why I chose this animal, because there's a chance this one have a little bit more energy, able to spit the food out a little bit more, right? When they start to lose a little energy, it actually becomes easier. It's a weird kind of a thing, right? But nevertheless, let's go ahead and do the same thing. Very gently, just kind of hold it like this. Again, frozen fuzzy right here. And I just want to open up that mouth, get it started. You can see this one's got a lot of fight in it already. I can already tell it's gonna be a battle, but I'm just gonna get it a little bit pushed down, hook its teeth a little bit on the fuzzy itself, and then, oh gosh, this has got a lot of energy. It's got a lot of energy. Just sit it like that, and then hopefully when I set it down, it's not gonna spit it out. But I have a feeling it's gonna spit it out, guys. I think this is gonna take me 2 or 3 times with this particular one. So we're gonna go ahead and set it down and see what happens. Kinda surprised right now that it's not fighting more, because it had so much energy. I thought when I set it down, it was just gonna explode and that fuzzy was just gonna come out of its mouth. So let's go ahead and see. Maybe we'll get lucky and get another snake that is cooperating right off the bat. I can see it's kinda taking a couple test bites, just like the last one, which is a great sign. As soon as you start seeing those test bites, that tells you that it might actually eat it. It's almost like something instinctually is turning on. They're saying, oh, wait a second, something's in my mouth. I can't get it out of my mouth. I must have to try to eat this. So let's see, there it goes again. Another little test bite. Isn't quite committed yet. And I've seen them go both ways this way. They'll either go and start eating, sometimes they'll go ahead and start thrashing again and get it out of their mouth. This one looks like it's pretty good. There's a good chance this one is actually gonna eat. Let's go ahead and just sit back and wait to see what's gonna happen. And all these little test bites are a great sign. It's not completely committed to eating yet, but again, these little test bites, this kind of like moving the jaw, stuff like that, that is what is really what we're looking for. So this guy looks like he's actually gonna eat, but again, this sometimes can take 2 minutes, this sometimes can take 20 minutes, so you have to have patience. And there it goes, it's starting to actually eat. Again, you can see the normal pattern of the, you know, kind of going back and forth eating, just like if it was on its own. Again, rather than force feeding it or tube feeding it, which gives it the nutrition, but doesn't give it this kind of learning or teaching technique, right? I've been doing this for a long time with these assist feedings, and it always works. I mean, every single snake I assist feed like this will eventually eat on its own. But once again, I don't want you to do this to snakes that have already fed in the past. This is not a technique for something that has already been feeding and just is on a fast. Only for snakes that have never eaten, and this is kind of teaching them how to eat. And there it is. That's basically the technique that I've been using forever to get these snakes to actually eat. And again, when you think about 1,000 snakes back there, we've got, you know, less than 20 that need to be assist fed. I mean, that's like less than 0.05% of our babies typically don't eat. But this is a great way to get that 0.05% eating, right? And get them on track. So again, I hope this helped you. I'm going to just power through the rest of these really quick and move on, because we have a lot left to do today. update with what's going on with the progress here. We've got the outside wall all done. This is actually, again, gonna be the camera room, control room. Really quick, I'm not gonna go into a big thing about it, but basically, this is the control room, right? So you can see into the podcast room. There'll be a desktop that goes all the way over here, all the way over here, and you can see this is our charging station for all our batteries, and then this is the crazy, you know, kind of menagerie of things that we need between power, HDMI, all kinds of cables for the cameras, all that type of stuff. We'll have cabinets on this side for all of our camera gear. We'll have kind of racks over here for stuff, so things are nice and easy and organized in here. This room is gonna look great. It's also gonna be where Jay, Anthony, Noah can hang out and edit and do all their type of stuff. But then they're working on the podcast room now, just getting some of the drywall up. So that should be done here in the next couple hours. Then we gotta tape it, mud it. We still have to paint everything. I mean, there's a lot of work to do, but it's actually starting to look like a room now. Quick unboxing, not too many snakes in this shipment. Just my buddy Jeff sent us some more stuff, and let's see what he sent us. He always has great animals, and I always get blown away by it. Oh, right off the rip, I got the nice one. Oh, it looks like it's starting to shed in the bag. So it's got some stuff shed on it. We'll get it in a soak, but ooh, doggy, this thing is a ripper. This is actually what they call a killer pie. So it's a super pastel piebald ball python, and oh my gosh, look at it. I mean, it stinks that it's shed in the bag and it's got stuff shed on it. Like I said, we'll get this in some water. It'll shed out within the next, you know, half hour, 45 minutes. And then we have just a little tiny piebald pastel right here. Beautiful little animal, not a high white one, but that killer pie, hoo doggy. I tell you what, that thing is amazing. Next up, we have actually a clown to a het clown clutch. Let's see what we got going on here. Looks like not a lot of clown action in this one here. Definitely got one little clown, really pretty little clown right here too. That's absolutely beautiful. Oh, looks like we've got one other clown in here. Just kind of unravel this ball of ball pythons. Double it. That's so stupid. We also have another clown ball python right here. So it looks like there's just two clowns and a bunch of het for clowns right here. And then that was it, guys. Just the pastel pie, the super pastel, or what they call a killer pie. A couple clowns, a bunch of het clowns, and that concludes the quick unboxing of snakes for the day. Looks like we're all done with the drywall down here. I'd already showed you the control room, camera room right here. And again, remember, there's gonna be a room here and a hallway here when we're finally done. So this won't have racks or anything. This will be a hallway that comes down here. And then this will be the door that goes into the podcast room. And like I mentioned before, there'll be a door over here to go into the New Caledonia gecko room. But this is the podcast area here now. So this is the complete room. It's gonna be dope. Again, what happens is these walls all get universal rock on them, so it feels like a cave in this building. We'll carpet the floor. Really dope table that my friends are gonna be dropping off here in the next couple days. I can't wait to show you that. And then of course we'll have our cameras up on the wall. We'll have TV monitors here, here, and here. So that way wherever you're sitting at the table, you can look across and actually see the monitors. Of course we'll also have the control room windows here that we can see the people in the control room. So it's come together. We still have a lot of work to do. Again, have to finish the walls, have to paint the ceiling, have to get carpet on the floor. floor, get the table in, do all the electrical, get all of the things set up. But I think we're, you know, a week and a half away from being completely done with the podcast room and probably the control room. And then we have to start on the New Caledonia room and the Colubrid room and the green room, which of course is where the couches and all that stuff will be, which will be a really cool place to just hang out and stuff like that. So hey, we're getting there, guys. Renovations are going well. I hope for anyone that is breeding snakes or something like that, you can use this assist feeding kind of technique to save some babies. But again, I continue to stress, do not assist feed your snakes if they're already eating. That's not gonna work the same way. This is something that works just for fresh babies. And again, it's something that I've been doing for a long time, has worked really well. If you enjoy this video, here is a playlist right up here of just tons of baby snakes you can roll through. I hope that you'll enjoy that. Up on this side, right in that corner, can you subscribe to my podcast channel called Checking In? You can subscribe to this vlog channel right over here. Turn your post notifications on. Have an absolutely wonderful day. Remember, be kind to someone, and I promise I'll see you tomorrow.